Let's solve some of the questions asked in the NET examination for the environment section. So we would be focusing across the questions of environment from the various shifts and the various sets of NET examination. Now the first question is, emission of hydrocarbons and carbon monoxide is low from diesels. Now a lot of you might get confused. Diesel engines are usually not preferred, but definitely when it comes to carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon emission, it is low. The reason being, they are more fuel efficient, so they have higher efficiency, durability and reliability, and as a result both the statements are correct and statement 2 is the correct explanation for 1, but that's not asked. So we have both the statement 1 and 2 as the correct option here. Okay, the next question talks about the aquatic environment which is affected by the polychlorinated biphenyls. Now these can originate in sewage, waste incinerators and toxic dumps. So all of these three are the right choices. Now they are basically mainly seen with sewage, and they are seen as a result of man-made chemicals that are there, which are mainly produced in cement, transformer oils or paints, and then electronic components, and then released into the aquatic environment or water bodies. So toxic dumps, waste incinerators and sewage effluents are the right option for this. The next is photovoltaic system. Now photovoltaic system, we first have what? We first have a solar cell, as we can see. Then we have a module. Module is followed by the array, and finally the array field. Okay, so solar cell, module, array and array field is the right sequence. Now these are the components of the solar paneling that is done, and these solar panels are combined with the inverter or any other mechanical hardware that is there to actually capture the energy from the sun and create energy, okay, electricity. The next is, the pollutants used in the calculation of AQI are PM10, particulate matter 10 and 2.5. We do have the table here, so it's particulate matter 10, particulate matter 2.5, nitrogen dioxide, ozone, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and ammonia. So those are the parameters that are taken into AQI category, and then we have the AQI rankings or the zones for AQI. We have covered a separate lecture on AQI, very very important, asked off and on every time. The next is, excessive noise pollution leads to. Now noise pollution definitely would affect your ears, can lead to irregular sleep patterns and lack of sleep, so insomnia, higher BP and respiratory diseases is not the correct option. So respiratory are affected by airborne air pollution, not the noise pollution. So this is not the choice, correct choice. And then reduced work efficiency is definitely the right choice. So you have A, B, C and E as the right option. The next is, high hazard waste. So highly hazardous waste would have pathogens that could spread, that could contaminate, radioactive waste and corrosive substances. So A, B and D would be the right option. If it is non-reactive, it's usually not part of highly hazardous, because if it is hazardous, it would be reactive, probably radioactive, and it would damage the storage, the transportation and the other systems as well. The Millennium Development Goal addresses the issue of poverty and hunger, maternal health and gender equality and empowerment. So A, B, D are the right options. We have completed a separate class on Millennium Development Goals. Every time you would have either one question from Millennium Development Goal or Sustainable Development Goal. So cover this very very carefully, very small topics and very very scoring topics. You know what kind of questions would be there. The next is, correct sequence of energy sources in terms of heat of combustion. So heat of combustion is lowest in case of green wood, followed by dry wood, followed by the natural fats, and the highest heat of combustion would be seen for methane. So if it is asking increasing order, we would have green wood, dry wood, natural fats and methane as the right sequence. The next question is, Over the years, from 2014 to 16, we have seen that carbon dioxide emissions have got stagnated. That is correct. It was 0.7%, then it was 0.2% for 2014, 15, 15, 16. The strong energy efficient improvement measures and low carbon technologies have been responsible for this. So both assertion and reason are correct, and reason is the right explanation for the assertion here. The last question is, according to the classification of Ministry of New and Renewable Energy and Central Energy Electricity Authority of India, small hydropower plants have a capability of 1 to 30 megawatts. So here we have 1 to 25 megawatts. So take care of the units as well, whether it's megawatt, kilowatt. So you can have same choices with megawatt and kilowatt. So be very, very attentive while solving the question. So one is the right option here. So those were some of the questions that were asked in the environment section of your NET paper 1. We would be covering the various sections of your NET paper 1 examination in the upcoming classes. Unit by unit, we would be covering the questions that were asked in the previous year 2020 examination. Stay tuned for many more updates further with us, and below we have the links for useful resources for you. Have a wonderful day ahead.